Shalom, all praises to Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai, and double honors to the apostles and the elders of Great Millstone Bashem Rakak Wadash. My name is Yakabo from Plain Tables Camp in Philly. This is on the disinformation board. And the video you see in the corner is basically a false prophet getting knocked out. And when he pulls the book up, you can see that he had nothing in the pages. It was supposed to represent, you know, it was really vain. What he was preaching was really vain. All right, that's what Esau preaches. Esau preaches vanity. All the religions are under the control of the Edomites. All right, Christianity, Roman Catholicism, the Egyptology, you know, the black conscious crap. That's all under the control of Esau, so-called the Caucasian. All right. Because he used to dwell in the caves. All right. So we're going to listen to what she has to say. She's going to correlate disinformation to child smuggling.
To play. I think what's important to note here is what the board is doing, which is continuing what is important disinformation related work that began under the former administration. The fact sheet that they put out, what they noted yesterday, what they noted in there is that this is meant to, one, the first bullet was about protecting privacy, civil rights, and civil liberties, and the First Amendment. They said the primary mission is to establish best practices to ensure that efforts to understand and respond to disinformation are done in ways that protect privacy, civil rights, and civil liberties. I'd also note that the first example they gave about what they're going to do is support the Department of Homeland Security's work, ongoing work, back to the former administration on to address how and understand how misinformation spread by human smugglers that prey on vulnerable populations attempting to migrate to the United States.
All right, so they're saying it's going to be used to understand things, which is a lie. I mean, because what they're trying to divorce their learning and their action, because you learn something and then you act on what you learn. All right, and they use smuggling and migrants and all that to appeal to people's emotions of care, of caring, you know. Now, we can go to New York Post. It says the mandate is not to adjudicate, to make formal judgment on decisions about problems. What is true or false online or otherwise? It will operate in a nonpartisan and apolitical manner. It basically meant to coordinate a lot of the ongoing work. That is happening. The focus is on disinformation that threatens the homeland. As I noted, when you say, if you label something as different information because it's very broad, you can say that it threatens the homeland. So long as whatever is being said is considered disinformation and it threatens the homeland, then whatever powers they have, they can act. All right, as I noted, which is things like that would incite violence and extremism. So that can be any type of protest or speech that they consider. Remember, they're the ones that are considering these things. They have to make it up within their minds what is exciting violence. That could be anything. It's up to them. What are the details on what they believe excites violent extremism? All right. And then she says, you know, again, this is not a complete list on, you know, it's not explaining much, but besides what she says, which is a few things. All right. Now, I don't know what the powers are that they have to actually act on, what they can actually do. You know, we look up the website, fact sheet, DHS Internal Working Group protects free speech and other fundamental rights when addressing disinformation that threatens the security of the United States. So disinformation, which is false information that is deliberately spread with the intent to deceive or mislead, can take many forms. When it comes to DHS's work, the department is focused on disinformation that threatens the security of American people, including disinformation spread by foreign states as Russia, China, Iran, and other adversaries such as transnational criminals. All right, for nearly 10 years. Let me see. I think I read. All right. It says in 2012, here's an example. During the Sandy Hook, Federal Emergency Management Agency corrected false information about the safety of drinking water and locations of shelters to protect and serve hurricane victims. FEMA has since built capacity to identify and respond to false information during major disaster responses. So I can see them using this when some catastrophe happens, them injecting, using this program. However they're going to do it, maybe they're controlling a news station or setting up a interview when the news stations are going to come, and they're going to just lie and say something didn't happen when it actually happened, or vice versa. All right, so it corrected false information about, so I don't know how they corrected that. Did they make an advertisement about it? This is not really that detailed, but how they actually going to make the correction. It just says they made the correction, but it doesn't tell you exactly what they did to make the correction. The department identifies disinformation that threatens the homeland through publicly available sources, research conducted by academic and other institutions, and information shared by other federal agencies and partners. DHS then shares factual information related to its mission to potentially impacted people and organizations. All right, but how are they spreading the information? And they're saying they're going to protect you. They're not going to say stifle free speech. That's what they're saying. All right. Remember when the Patriot Act. And National Defense Authorization Act, I forget which one, but they can arrest any citizen and interrogate them indefinitely without no representation. So I forget which one exactly they can do this. But what certain people say, well, they haven't done it yet. Well, we don't know that because they don't have to tell you. It says, I can find about work. That's it. It's not really that long, actually, but they don't actually, unless I'm missing it. It says, while protecting free speeches and other fundamental rights, right, so Secretary Mayor Koss will request that the Bipartisan Homeland Security Council make recommendations for how the department can most effectively, appropriately address disinformation that poses a threat to the homeland. See? And that's where it becomes vague, because if they say it affects the homeland, then it's considered disinformation, whatever information is out there. And definitely what we're saying is that, well, our freedom of speech, which we have here in America, it's a law that we have the right to say, to speak our piece. Maybe not say anything, but, you know, if we read in the scriptures, we can, you know, read the scriptures and tell you, you know, what's going to happen in the future. And then we believe that this is just another tactic on how they're trying to limit what people say. All right, and they can just label it as disinformation. And that's what pretty much everyone's concerned about outside of the scriptures. Like, wait a minute, are they going to try to police, you know, information that we receive and that we hear about? All right. So this is their page. Just type in disinformation Homeland Security or DHS. Disinformation DHS and their page will come up. This just came out yesterday, May 2nd. All right. So, yeah, 10 minutes. Vulnerable to malicious actors often spread disinformation to exploit vulnerable individuals and the American public, including during national emergencies. And if a false flag might be ready to come up, where they're trying to control the narrative. All right, so let's watch out for that. That's what we believe they're attempting to do. Or what they're setting in place. Not attempting to do anything. They're setting it in place. And then to give the example during the Sandy Hook. During Hurricane Sandy, they said they corrected some false information, which they more than likely delivered to news stations. And they repeated it. So let's beware of that. So we understand that we have the information. So you can't make us forget what we learned. All right. This is Matthew 12:23. But he that received seed unto good ground is he that heareth the word and understandeth it, which also beareth fruit and bringeth forth, and some 100-fold, and some 60, and some 30. All right, bringeth forth. Bring it forth. Poyo. Let's make ready, prepared to render anything. To be the author of something. To act rightly, to execute, to carry out. So we have the seed, and we're actually performing the thing that's within the seed. The seed is the word. Of Yahweh Bashem Yahushai. Right. That's one sign that you're of the elect. That you actually act on the good seed. The seed that's on a good ground. Alright. And then the seed that was on a good ground was them that heard the word and understood it and actually brought forth fruit. I mean, they acted on the word, and then other people acted on the word that they taught. Alright. Those are the elect. All right, Esau is he's the false prophet in the video. All right, it says you look up Job 18. It speaks about the wicked, right? And the wicked they have their laws. They have their way of living, their philosophy. All right, it says 18:5. Yeah, the light of the wicked shall be put out, and the spark of his fire shall not shine. And the light shall be dark in his tabernacle, and his candle shall be put out with him. Yeah, there's the sun, the moon, the stars are going to set on Esau. And then the whole chapter is good, but I'm going to start at 16. His roots shall be dried up beneath, and above shall his branch be cut off. His remembrance shall perish from the earth, and he shall have no name in the streets. All right. So Esau is compounding all these laws together to leave out, you know, any gaps. They're basically destroying the Constitution. All right. And destroying, you know, natural laws, you know, be able to walk up and down the street free and, you know, and not fear, you know, persecution, you know. Esau is slowly eroding these laws so they can have a tighter grip on the citizens. So when they go to implement their new world order, it's a lot easier for them. And it's conditioning people also. That's really the thing. It's conditioning you to accept, you know, tyranny. His remembrance shall be perished from the earth. His remembrance shall perish from the earth, and he shall have no name in the streets. He shall be driven from light into darkness and chased out of the world. He shall neither have son or nephew among his people, nor any remaining in his dwellings. Well, in Babylon, America is going to be completely erased. But in the kingdom, when they're in bondage, when they're in slavery, they're not going to have any good name. Their nephews, they're not going to have a good name. They're not going to be great. That it's going to be servants, workers. And we're the working class now. Now, in the kingdom, Esau is going to be the working class. We're not going to be working at all. They that come after him shall be astonished at this, at his day, as they that went before were frightened. Surely such are the dwellings of the wicked, and this is the place of him that knoweth not the power. All right. The reason why Esau is compounding all these laws on top of each other is so he can condition people to the new world order, all right, which is tyranny. All right, so it's gradually descending into tyranny. All these systems, all these societies that supposedly that were freer, like Australia, like Canada and America, Britain, are slowly getting our freedom eroded until they establish that order. All right, but as you see in the clip, Esau's the false prophet. He's the main false prophet. All right. A prophet is a teacher. All right. They're the same thing. All right. It says, Nahum 3:3, the horseman lifteth up both the bright sword and the glittering spear, and there is a multitude of slain. That's the nuclear fire. And great number of carcasses. There is none end of their corpses. They stumble upon the corpses. You know, fallout's going to be the corpses. All right. But the center, where the blast hits, mainly in America, is going to be completely incinerated. Nothing's going to be left. Absolutely nothing. There's going to be no corpses in Babylon, America. But other places where the fire from heaven comes down, you're going to have fallout. The outer edges of where the nuclear fire hits, you would have actual corpses. All right, because of the multitude of the whoredom of the well-favored harlot, the mistress of witchcrafts, that selleth nations through her whoredoms and families through her witchcrafts. Those are the Edomites. All right, the well-favored harlot is the daughter of Babylon, the harlot in the book of Revelation. All right, Nahum was prophesying the same thing John prophesied. Well, Nahum prophesied at first. Behold, I am against thee, saith the Lord of hosts, and I will discover thy skirt upon thy skirts upon thy face. All right, what he's about to do is being revealed. All right, I will shew the nations thy nakedness and the kingdoms thy shame. And I will cast abominable filth upon thee and make thee vile and will set thee as a gazing stock. All right. Let me look up gazing stock. It means to look upon. Appearance, a spectacle. All right. See. Appearance, sight. Now, we look it up in the Greek, we have paradigma. All right, which means a pattern, a model, an example, precedent, an example. I will set thee as a precedent, or I set thee as an example, an earlier event or action, meaning how Esau ruled, how he lived, his morals. All right. His laws is going to be the embodiment of who Esau is going to be as an example of how not to be. An earlier event, meaning Esau ruling or action, that is regarded as example or guide to be considered in subsequent similar circumstances. All right. So an example. Right. A model, a pattern. All right. So the Lord said he's going to set him as a gazing stock. Where are we at, Nahum? They're going to look at him and he's going to be an example. All right. Nineveh completely ruined. Now this Nineveh is referring to not the ancient Nineveh, but modern day Nineveh. on modern day Assyria, which is America, Babylon America. All right, this spiritual name for America. All right, because this didn't happen to ancient Nineveh. Stumble upon a court. Yeah, this didn't happen. All right. All right. It says 2 Peter. Let me start from 17. But it's referring to the false prophets. Remember, the chief false prophet are the Edomites. All right. Those are the chief false prophets. But there were false prophets among the people, even as there shall be false teachers among you, who probably shall bring in damnable heresies, even denying the Lord that brought them, and bring upon themselves swift destruction. All right. Go down to 17. False prophets, these, and when you learn their doctrine, you become unfruitful. These are wells without water, clouds that are carried with a tempest, to whom the mist of darkness is reserved forever. So when you follow the doctrine of the world, you're in darkness. For when they speak great swelling words of vanity, they allure through the lust of the flesh, through much wantonness, which means uncontrollable lust, uncontrollable actions, those that were clean escape from them who live in error. All right. While they promised them liberty, all right, and that's what they're doing with these laws, they're protecting vulnerable populations or groups. I'll bring it back up. Such malicious actors often spread disinformation to exploit vulnerable individuals and the American public, including during national emergencies. And some national emergency is going to happen, and they're going to have this league set up ready to lie. They say they ain't protecting you, but they're really, because remember, they're the same ones that used to say it was healthy to smoke. They used to put cocaine in Coca-Cola. They put fluoride in water. They add it. Not what naturally exists. They add fluoride to water. They say that vampire shots are good for you. Remember, slavery was legal and it was common. And they benefited off of our ancestors being enslaved. These things are all legal. And you believe for 1 second that they're not going to abuse these powers. Remember, they're not really abusing these powers. These powers are set up to put you in a cage, to limit you. All right. Peter's. While they promised them liberty, they themselves are the servants of corruption, for of whom a man is overcome, of the same is he brought into bondage. And you think you escaped, and through, let's say, the government or governments, they actually put you in bondage. While they promised them liberty. All right. I have one more word here. We got aslegia. What was this? It's wantonness. It was this word here. And wanton means sexually unrestrained, having many casual sexual relationships, typically used of a woman. It says her cheeks burned as she recalled how forward she had been, how wanton. Yeah, it's basically a woman that's says dated. That's how they used to speak. Maybe a forward woman, outspoken. Those women were considered, you know, shameless, immodest, indecent. now that women have been liberated, sexually liberated, you know, they don't really use that word regarding women anymore. But in general, you know, we know that, that the word is still very valid. You know, that's what it means. All right. Unabridled lust. All right. So that brings me us to the end of the lesson. All right. Start off with this. Them protecting vulnerable populations. And they say it's not to adjudicate information online. All right. But remember, they can amend things. They can add clauses. And it's ultimately, you know, to bring in tyranny. All right, which is total control. All right, so just be aware that these things exist and understand that, well, Esau in the end is not going to win. Our power is stronger. It's the end. This is going to be the end of all Esau's laws, Revelation 19 and 20, and his religions and his false information, his false doctrines, Revelation 19 and 20. And the beast was taken, and with him the false prophet that wrought miracles before him, with which he deceived them that had received the mark of the beast and them that worship his image. These both were cast alive into the lake of fire and brimstone, a fire burning with brimstone. Now they could in the future say that what I just said here is disinformation, that the American government is not going to be destroyed by nuclear fire from the different EU and Russian countries. That have nuclear power. They could say what I just said is disinformation. And the lake of fire is the European Union countries that have nuclear capability, and Russia and other powers that have nuclear power. They're going to shoot their missiles on America. That's the fire and brimstone. America's going to become a lake of fire. They could say that's disinformation and that's scaring people. Remember, it's open-ended. It's not a specific. Because it could evolve beyond the wording. Or they can make it mean what they want based upon the result they say it is. Like if we say something and then say like 9/11, then something like that happens. Then they can equate it to, well, it was these particular things that were said on this date and in this manner that is considered disinformation and an extremist point of view, which threatens the American people. Remember, Esau, it was a web of lies and probable cause. All right, so hope you edified. Shall we on to the next lesson?
It's time for you to leave these people alone.
May I?
Thomas, I think you're out of it. It's time for you to leave these people alone.
May I?
It's time for you to leave these people alone.
May I?
Thomas, I think you're out of a job.
No, no, Debo!
Oh, would you look at this? It's time for you to leave these people alone.
May I?
Thomas, I think you're out of a job.
No, no, Debo!
Oh, would you look at this?
Oh, wait.